Right, I'm in the bivouac for end of stage 9. I've been talking to Chris Evans, who's Cyril Despres' manager, who's waiting around basically at the motorhome. Cyril's just come in. It looks like he's had an absolutely cracking day. These are just provisional results, but I'm hearing he's won the stage significantly from Juan Barreda over 4 minutes, but more significantly, his main rival, David Castor, reportedly has hit a cow and has a dislocated shoulder. He's carrying on with the stage, but he is obviously lost an awful lot of time. I don't know exactly how long he has lost. It's quite a scene here, actually. Cyril's come straight in. He's the first rider back. He's parked his bike. He didn't even talk to anyone really that was waiting, apart from one of his assistants, who he asked to get his mountain bike out, put on the on the training turbo trainer, and he's basically stood now doing an interview. Well, he's got about 30 members of the press around him, TV channels, and he's pedalling away on a cool down, talking to the press, conducting interviews, holding court, and not even out of breath. Quite impressive scene, to be perfect honest. Hopefully we're going to be able to grab a word.
No, not more. It was. I start 5:09 and it's 17:09. I'm a bit afraid for the other competitor because they will arrive late, huh, I think.
But how hard was it for you?
It was hard. 12 hours on a bike is never easy, but I was expecting this this day. In 6 months, you know, I prepare myself just in case I have to push one hard day, you know, and then I know this piece here in Cordoba, you know, with all the WRC I watch on TV. I know this is something that I like, and today I wanted to enjoy and push a little bit, and then stage victory is not so bad, no?
Was there a moment to enjoy it?
No, it's the whole day. Yeah. I mean, you know, when you like to do what you are doing and everything is going well and you still have a little margin of taking care about yourself and your bike, you know, not pushing 200% but only 80-90, and then we can say I enjoy a lot.
For you to be back to Dakar routine after a day off?
No. There's no Dakar routine. Is when you enjoy, you everything is nice.
So you told us yesterday that you had nothing to lose after going into the rest day. Was it always the plan to go for full on attack today?
Well, yeah, of course. You know, it's something special here. This is a place which you need basically two things, apart of a good bike, of course, but you need some good legs to push on the footrest to keep the adherence on every corner. I don't know if we did hundreds of corners today. And then you need a good pair of legs, and thanks to my trainer, which built a good physical base, you know, Joel. He's from Argentina, but he lives in Andorra. And then you need also to trust your tire, and Michelin, and all the tests we make with Michelin was so helpful. And today, the combination of both, plus a little bit excess of excitement, you know, yeah, make a good result and a good day.
But after 12 hours on the motorbike and now sitting on the cycling bike, you can't get enough of.
No, you know, you understand that Red Bull give us wings, but they give also some good tips. And since 2 years now in the DTC, Diagnostic and Training Center from Red Bull in Austria, we analyzed that my regeneration of acid lactate is can be 30 to 40% quicker if I do 20-25 minutes. And then it's no bullshit, it's just numbers. And another 9 minutes and I'm done.
And you feel that really helps?
Yeah, of course, yeah. If I've been in a good shape today, it's because 2 days ago I make 25 minutes, and yesterday, rest day, I make 30. Yeah, it's if it work, I do.
Are you on first ever?
Si.
Thank you very much, Cyril. Well, we were able to get a quick word with Cyril there, or quite a long word with Cyril there. Like I say, there was an awful lot of press there, TV. He was holding court whilst pedalling away. Impressive stuff, to be perfectly honest. I've seen a few guys in short circuit racing do that sort of thing, but not after riding for 12-4 hours on the bike all day and absolutely dominating the stage. Quite a humbling experience, and I just need to stress that none of his rivals are back yet. So he, after playing it very cool all week, or certainly the first half of the race, he really has pulled the pin today and fired a massive warning shot to his rivals. He may not be leading overall, but ultimately it's his teammate in front of him, and who would ultimately, if he had to, yield to Cyril.